إن الحمد لله إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونستهديه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا إنه من يهده الله فهو المهتدي ومن يضلل فلن تجد وليا مرشدا وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله شهادة تنجينا من عذاب النار ويدخلنا الجنة من غير سابقة عذاب ولا عقاب وأشهد أن محمد عبده ورسوله وصفيه من خلقه وحبيبه أشهد أنه قد بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة ومحى الغمة وجاهد في الله حق الجهاد حتى أتاه اليقين فصلاة وسلاما على عبدك ونبيك محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا. يقول الله سبحانه وتعالى بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم أحسب الناس أن يتركوا أن يقولوا آمنا وهم لا يفتنون. ولما اختلف الأنصار والمهاجرون مع بعضهم أتى رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم وقال لهم أبدعوى الجاهلية وأنا بين ظهوركم أو كما قال عليه الصلاة والسلام. أما بعد oh praise to Allah, oh praise to Allah, the one, the only, the one who should be worshipped. I bear witness that he is the creator of this universe and he is the one who should be worshipped. I bear witness that Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam is his messenger. True mercy sent to us. If you follow his path, inshallah, we'll be in Jannah. Amma ba'd. Today, I have a story. The story, if you were coming from a place like mine, back home, all everything you want to get is lines. You stand in lines. And the funny part is, anything you want to buy, you go online, line, and you get it. The story comes like that. One, coming to a place and he found a huge line. He said, okay, I stand in line to see if I can buy something out of this line. And he stood hour, 2 hours, the line is not moving. And he looked up to him, knocked on the one in front of him. He said, why are you standing here? He said, I don't know. I'm just standing. What? And the line behind him got grower up. I said, okay, why are you standing here? I don't know. Talked to the one in front of him. Why are you standing here? I don't know. He reserved his spot and he moved until he reached the first one in line. He was standing in front of a closed shop. And he said, why are you standing here? And he said, I don't know. My shoelaces got out of its place, I went down, I put my hand on the shop and started, and it took me some time. While I'm doing that, 3-4 people stood behind me. And then, he said, okay, no problem. Then what? Then people came after him and said, then there is nothing here, the shop is empty. I said, yes. There's nothing there. He said, yes. Then move. I said, no. This is the first time I stand in the first of the line. Why this story? Why I'm telling this story? The meaning of it, the idea of it. Every one of us is standing in a line. What's your line? Every one of us is standing in a specific line. Sometimes the lines are good, sometimes the lines are bad, but still you're standing in line. We call it in Arabic at-ta'assub. You stand behind that idea. Okay, I'm standing behind an idea. What should I do? And when I was searching, I found 7 lines. And most of us, or some of us, or none of us, depending on every one of us, is standing behind one line. Let's see how many lines you are standing. And definitely there is more. But I was quick. I said, okay, let me quick. 2-3 hours is enough. Let me, don't dig more. But there are some more lines we can stand in. The first line, definitely. The first line you can stand behind is religion. Religion. Okay. How to deal with each other based on what? I'm talking about the same sect of religion even. I'm not talking about another sect. When we talk about, as for example, Sunni and Ahmadi and Qadiani. No, I'm not talking about Sunni. Even though there's nothing called Sunni, by the way. Every one of us is Muslim. We're standing in front of Allah, I'm not going to Allah and say, okay, Allah, I have the green card. What? Oh, I am a Muslim Sunni. Allah didn't say that. Allah said, Muslim, full stop. When Sayyidina Yusuf, said, Tawaffani Musliman. He didn't say Musliman Sunniyan, Musliman whatever. No, there is no qualifier after Muslim. There is no qualifier. We don't have qualifiers after Muslim. You are a Muslim, full stop. Sometimes even inside the each sect, you find people standing, oh, you know, I like this one, I like this one, and I like this sheikh, and this sheikh. And you take a deep breath and say, why are you standing in this line? Why are you standing in the line of, I want to be right? Look at this, the Sahaba themselves. That's what the Hadith has narrated. The Sahaba had a fight between one Ansari and one Muhajiri. The Ansar and the Muhajirin. And definitely, immediately, a man from Ansar said, Ya Al-Ansar, oh Ansar, come, help! The Muhajiri want to win. And the Muhajiri, come on, we have people here. Al Muhajiri, come! And everyone came with the swords. This is the Sahaba, the best people in the world, came with swords. And the Prophet heard, came running towards them. What are you doing? Abida'wa al-Jahiliyyah. You still have Jahiliyyah in your head. By the way, Jahiliyyah means not only before the Islam. We have Jahiliyyah until today, until the hereafter. Until before the hereafter, there's people stands in line. I want to be right, and no one is wrong. No one is except me. I'm the only right, which is not right. Al-Imam al-Shafi'i said, I wish when I debate with anyone that the right comes from him, not from me. Why? Because I know how to control myself and show myself the right path. This is the first one. And look at the debate with this religion. When we talk about religion, again, I'm in the same first one. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when he talked to us, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talking to us, what did he say? Wallahi, it's a beautiful verse I found. Look at this. قُلْ Allah is saying, قُلْ O Muhammad, say, مَنْ يَرْزُقُكُمْ مِنَ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ قُلْ إِلَّهِ Allah is the only one. وَإِنَّ Allah is talking to himself. وَإِنَّ أَوْ إِيَّاكُمْ The disbelievers. عَلَى هُدًى أَوْ فِي ضَلَالٍ مُبِينٍ In the debate, you don't say, I'm right, you're wrong. No, Allah himself didn't say that. Inna aw iyyakum, one of us is in the right or the wrong. Let's think. Always be humble when you debate with someone, especially in religion. Don't think that your ideas are the absolute idea. When we discuss some things in religion, oh, I'm sure 100%. How are you sure? Oh, because I read it. How do you know? And you keep debating, maybe it's wrong, what you read is wrong. Then really you have to accept and think. No standing in line, even in religion. But you follow, you try your best to follow the right way. The second worst thing that we do sometimes, and definitely I'll see some smiles when I say it. You know, I'm from Egypt, I'm the best, I'm from the mother of the world. And you're from Pakistan, the place that the Quran came down, and Syria is the place that the mahshar will start, and everyone was debating, and oh, I'm from Canada, you know, I'm Canada, come on, I'm Canadian. I'm American, I am. Sorry, who said that you have this as a good thing? Who said that? Allah is the one who shows that where you're gonna be born. I'm here from almost more than 23 years, 26 years before, or 30 years. Who thought about I'm coming to Canada? Who said that? Who's planning? Who said that you're going to be born in Pakistan, in India, in Syria, in Iraq? Who said that? Who said that? When are you going to be born? Allah, Prophet said, "Unsur akhaka zaliman aw mazluman." Help your brother. Your brother. In any in Islam, in Iraq, in Syria, Egyptian, Syrian, Syria. Help him. Maybe I'll help someone else. How? Oh Prophet, how? Should I go with him anyway, right or wrong? The Prophet said no. No. Unsur akhaka mazluman, to support him and help him. But if he's daliman, if he's an oppressor, stop him. don't stand in line because he's the same nationality. No. If someone brings you to be a judge, be fair judge. Hear both. Don't have heart because he's the same nationality. You go with the same nationality. No, don't do that. Never do that. The third one, the ideology. You know, I'm from the same ideology as yours. Come on, you have to stand beside me. If you're wrong, no, I'm the same ideology. I have the same concept, the same ideas. Follow me. No, I'm following the truth. If you are on the truth, I'll follow you. If not, not. You're normal. The ideology of everyone. And the ayah which I like in this part is أَرَأَيْتَ مَنِ اتَّخَذَ إِلَاهَهُ هَوَاهُ. And most, this is one of the scariest ayah I find. Everyone thinks that he is on the right path. Every one of us, definitely every one of us. No one will debate that. You're doing that because you think you're right. Maybe after you do it, yeah, okay, I did something wrong here. When you're driving, you're speeding. I need to, why you're speeding? Because I want to reach, you put excuses. I want to reach early. Excuse. Oh, why you're turning quickly right? Because I want to get out of this exit. And after you go, I almost crossed someone behind me. You will find excuse and then we think, okay, why did I do it? No. The next one, and this is a hard one because I see everyone, even me sometimes doing it. The gender jokes. And the gender, okay, the man, because the man said so. The women, you know the women, even we have a joke in back home. Ask the woman and do the other way around. If they say right, go left. سألوهم خلفوهم in Arabic. سألوهم خلفوهم. Which is, where do you get this? So there, the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام in Sulh al-Hudaybiyah. In Sulh al-Hudaybiyah. Umm Salama was with him. The Prophet commanded everyone. Everyone, slaughter and cut your hair. No Sahabi did it. Even Sayyidina Abu Bakr didn't do it. No Sahabi did it. He said it once. And he got so angry. How? No one is obeying me. And he went to inside his tent. And who is there? Umm Salama. He told her the story. I said, calm down, O Prophet. They love you. Don't tell anyone. Go out. Do it yourself. Slaughter. Cut your hair. And that's it. Don't talk to anyone. Umm Salama, a lady. Can you talk to her? He went outside, obeyed her. Then, سألوهم وخلفوهم, ask them and disobey them. This is not right. This is not right. Even the good in our Islam, every good example in the book of Islam is women, are women. If you look around, وَضَرَبَ اللَّهُ مَثَلًا لِلَّذِينَ آمَنُوا إِمْرَأَةً. There really, no. There is no segregation between genders. Sometimes you have jokes, crap jokes between men and women. We sometimes follow, because he's a man I'm following, because she's a woman I'm not, or vice versa. Women will say the same. If she's a woman I'm following. Again, lines, don't stand in line. If she's saying the truth, I'll give an example. Balqis. When Sayyidina Sulaiman came, إِنَّ الْمُلُوكَ, he said, إِنَّ الْمُلُوكَ, the kings, when they come to a city, they destroy the city. And وَكَذَلِكَ يَفْعَلُونَ, and they do it. There are so many debates who said that. But anyway, for now, we'll take it that Allah is confirming that on her statement. SubhanAllah, this is women. Next. Our next one is, especially the youth, sit. The youth, subhanAllah, I'm the Raptors, you are Liverpool. I'm Chelsea. Oh no, I'm Ahli, I'm Zamal, I'm not sure what Pakistan you have. Cricket, they have cricket. Oh, this team, I'm with this team or that team, or I'm fighting with this team, and they start a fight for nothing. People are playing, and you erupt the fight. And you ask yourself, why are you fighting? Because my player is better than your player. And why are you fighting still? Because I have to. No, you don't have to do anything. then asabiyya in riyadha, in athlete, to be athlete, oh, you know, my player missed that and your referee did this. And so the riyadha, the athleticism is good that to watch. Sometimes I watch. I watch games, I watch soccer, I watch basketball. But at the end, I don't have anything against anyone. Because why my brother beside me hates me and I hate him for something both of us didn't do? I'm checking for Liverpool because Mo Salah is there and he's choosing whatever, and because someone is there, and at the end of the game, because this game won, I fight with him or he fights with me. What? Or the Raptors are winning and LeBron James got Lakers, and at the end, because this happened and the F word, R word, S word, what are you doing? Who is writing what? The angels here are writing who won, or writing what comes of my mouth and what comes and stays in my heart? It's written here, whatever I say. Then why you say it? Then al-asabiyya. Rasulullah when someone came to him and said, O Prophet, advise me. قَالَ لَا تَغْضَبْ. Don't be angry. Advise me. Don't be angry. Advise me. Don't be angry. 3 times. Advise me. Don't be angry. Why are you angry? Why you, with your anger, stand the line of fighting? The next one, and everyone, I believe everyone will understand. Even back home, I live in this mansion, and I live, my father, you know, he's a head of state, and, you know, I'm from this family, honorable family, and though you're from nowhere. From where you are? Oh, from this part of the city? Oh, ghettos, come on. What are you talking about? This is a ghetto place. I don't want to talk to you. He's a good man. No. He's not good. Then really, again, you stand beside your family status. I'm from this cult. I'm from this group. I am from this, even in the same place. I'm not talking about different places now. Everything I chose from the same place. But you're living in this part of the city, I'm living in that part of the city. But he is good. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said what? Inna akramakum indallahi aghnakum afqarkum ahsankum ahsankum shaklan. No. Atqakum. Wat taqwa, and the Prophet defined taqwa. Wat taqwa hauna. At taqwa is what's inside your heart. It has to be inside the heart, not anywhere else. The last one, and I chose it to be the last one because really, even my youth here sometimes do it. My son, where are you going? I'm going to the brown school in this area. And you know, this is a white school. This is a hijabi school. What? I'll meet you at 2 o'clock. Egyptian time or Canadian time? I said, what? Wallahi, when I heard the first time from maybe 20 years, what are you talking about? Egyptian time or Canadian time? What's that? Or Arab time or Muslim time? What are you talking about? I said, no, yeah, because when you say inshallah, this means you're not happening. If I see you at 2 o'clock, 2 o'clock means from 2 to 10 o'clock. But Canadian time, 2 o'clock is 2 o'clock, which is not true. Islam, Dhuhr prayer at 1, whatever, you have to pray at that time. Maghrib prayer at 6:15, you have to pray at 6:15. Our time is perfect, but we abuse it. We abuse it. Oh, he's colored. He's black. He's white. By the way, there's no white. I'm black. By the way, let's be firm. There's no white or black. If white, go to a doctor. If I'm black, go to a doctor, because there's no white or black. It's all or brown. All of us beige, light beige to dark brown. That's it. All the colors. We don't have white or black. We don't. Ask a doctor. But really, we say, oh, we want this someone. Oh, he's black. He's brown. He's whatever. This is not in Islam. We don't segregate people depending on the color. We never do that. This is 7 lines I chose today. And there are more. But the time, I know the time will not help me. 7 lines. Every one of us, how many you're standing behind? What should you do if you want to get out of these lines, if you are standing in one of them? And at the end, the first one standing in line, he doesn't know why he's standing. The shop is closed. There's nothing there to stand. This is, inshallah, I'll say in the second part of khutbah, قُلُوا قَوْلِي هَذَا وَاسْتَغْفِرُوا رَبَّكُمْ وَاسْتَغْفِرُوا رَبَّكُمْ وَاسْتَغْفِرُوا إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعين ونستغفره ونستهديه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا ما بعد. I'll finish with the story of Abu Dhar al-Ghafari and Bilal ibn Rabah. They had a fight, and Abu Dhar from Mecca, from Prince, and Bilal from Habasha. And they had a fight, and Abu Dhar told him, look at him and said, and again, he was dark skinned again, Bilal, because he's from Habasha, from Africa. He said, Abu Dhar told him, Yabna Sawda, your mother is black. That's what he said. Abu Dhar told Bilal. What's the problem here? If I tell you, if someone's Syrian in front of me, he's you're a Syrian. Okay, or you're a Pakistani. Okay, what does it mean? Oh, you're dissing me. Okay, you're dissing me somehow. And Bilal understood it's a dissing mode. I mean, from Abu Dhar. And he couldn't do anything. He left and told who? His doctor. I like always to say, the doctor of the doctors, Rasulullah. He went to him and told him, Abu Dhar told me that. And the Prophet waited until Abu Dhar came. And he frowned a little bit. And he looked at him and said, oh Abu Dhar, innaka mri'un fika jahiliyya. You have something wrong in your heart. Fix it. Very nice. Very good. And now, imagine with me that someone comes to you and tells you, you make me strong. What are you going to do? Are you going to stand firm behind your line again? I said, I'm better than him. You know, I'm more knowledgeable than him. You know, I'm from that part of the world. I know, I'm more religious than him. I'm more white, black, green, yellow, whatever my color is. Or you said yes. If it's truthful, yes. Or try to convince me otherwise. But if you hurt someone, you hurt someone. If you hurt someone, you already hurt someone. This means that someone is feeling bad. It's okay sometimes to say, I'm sorry. What Bilal did to finish the story, if you don't know the story, Abu Dhar immediately went to the ground and asked his brother Bilal, put your step on my face. This is, put your step on my face, Bilal. And Sayyidina Bilal said, bring him up and hugged him. Because they love each other. At the end, mistakes happen. But when someone reminds you that you did a mistake, what happened? What happened? A good man is, if you get angry, you return quickly to the right. If someone reminds you. If Sayyidina Umar radiallahu anhu was so angry to stop him, what do you say? Anyone in the place, Ya Umar, yes, Ittaqillah. Immediately Sayyidina Umar goes back a step and he thinks, why he said Ittaqillah? I did something wrong. Question yourself, what did I do? Anything you stand behind, if I fight with your brother from a game of soccer or basketball or whatever, or you fight your brother because he's Egyptian, Syrian, Pakistani, who is writing, do you think, who is writing the Hasanat or Sayyat? Which one? The right or the left? Any act, I was telling your life, every nanosecond is counted. Wallahi, I was joking with my, it's a joke now. I was talking to my brother, my family, and I was talking, if, I don't want to do it now. If we say, hey Siri, maybe it will then. It hears me. If I say something, it hears me. It's a machine. Just a simple machine, a human did it for a human. It hears you. How about Allah's creation? What do they hear? Not only they hear, they hear you, they see you, they take a picture from you right and left. And how do you say it? I said the khutbah before. I can tell you good morning, or good morning, or good morning. The way I say it makes a difference. The way, the smile. That's why I tell everyone to smile. Give sadaqah, it's free. You take hasanat for free. Free hasanat. Let's conclude, because time is running on me and I have to go. How to gain and get out of these lines? Think. If you cannot do it while you're standing in the line, after you go from your anger, because maybe a Pakistani, Egyptian, Syrian, whatever told you something, think, did I do this wrong? Or go to a brother who is good and ask him, I did this, is this right or wrong? Because sometimes the heart, sometimes you're trying to stand and be firm with your mind. Because you think you're better. And no one is better than no one. The word better, by the way, is wrong. Why? Because I can be better than my son here in, and you give him a khutbah. But he is definitely better than me in many things. Starting with Fortnite, or NBA, or whatever, or any game, or even this phone. My son does many things on that phone, I don't know how to do it. He's better than me, there is no one better than no one. No one can claim better. No, the word better means that you are better and he's better. Then really, if someone comes to you and says, you did this wrong, thank you, brother. And think why he's saying that. Why he's saying I'm wrong. Maybe I'm wrong. Maybe I'm one of the lines that I'm standing and there is nothing at the end. I'm just standing behind the line of nationality, of color, of religion, of. Really, we have to revisit our intentions. Really, we need to know that one day we stand in front of Allah and every second of our lives will be shown to us. Not only shown to us, the witnesses will be coming for every second. I remind you, there are seven bridges. The seventh bridge is the one which will be questioned about everything you do in life. Everything. You said that, oh, I'm giving the khutbah. And one of you brothers will say, oh, he looked at me in the khutbah with a dissing mode. I didn't do it. No, you were trying to get it because you need hasanat. And I lay up a witness, I have a camera, I didn't say it, I didn't mean it. I'm sorry if I offended anyone because I have a loud voice. I have a loud voice, I know that part. Someone brother told me, lower your voice, I wish I can, but I cannot. Forgive me. Some of the hasanat you do, two things quickly inshallah. First, Ramadan is coming, 2 months to go. Ramadan, what are your plans in Ramadan? What are your plans? Are you planning to eat and watch movies and stay all night watching some whatever? Or are you planning to use it and read the Quran? Try to have an idea to read tafsir of Quran. Try to acknowledge a little bit of Quran. Try to learn and understand more Quran. Have some dua, prepare the dua. Prepare yourself, by the way, you cannot jump on Ramadan. Some people say, when Ramadan comes, I'll be ready. Are you sure? Are you ready? The fridge has empty spaces and you go get baklava, kunafa, makbous, whatever, you can do that? Or you are ready, Ramadan means fasting, means you relax your stomach and get ready. What's ready means? You have to prepare. Make dua, a lot of dua, to reach Ramadan, the Sahaba used to do that, reach Ramadan. I always give the example when between the sujood. Remember, I'm trying to put it every time I go to the khutbah. Subhan Rabbi al-A'la, and you sit between the sujood, what you say? Allahumma ghfir li wa li walidayya wa li ashabi huq alayhi wa li ghfir li wa li walidayya wa muslimin ajma'in. Oh Allah, forgive me, forgive my parents, and forgive every Muslim. This means that, imagine with me, or like one of the scholars I was hearing, that he said that we have 1.6 billion, let's assume half of them are praying. Let's give it from me 500 only. Then each prayer, if you pray dhuhr only, you do sujood between the sujood how many? 4 times. This means that 4 times, times 500 million, is 2 billion hasana in just one prayer. In dhuhr prayer, in asr prayer, in isha prayer. Very simple hasanat we can do. When you make dua to the Muslimin, all of them gives you hasanat. Simple acts you can do. What else can you do? After prayer, you remember, the Prophet said, say, SubhanAllah 39, Alhamdulillah 30 grams, Allah Akbar 30 grams. This is equal to a lot of hasanat and so much more. Time has gone on me, I have to stop. But remember, goodness always is there. And goodness, you need to search for it. Final, remember to say Astaghfirullah in every part of your life. Even after we finish prayer, what is the first thing we say after we finish prayer? Astaghfirullah. Even prayer, Astaghfirullah. Remember, we are weak. And may Allah forgive us and accept us. Allahumma hadina fi man hadayt. Allahumma hadina fi man hadayt. Wa'afina fi man afayt. Allahumma ajma'na wa la tufarriqna. Allahumma balighna Ramadan. Allahumma balighna Ramadan. Allahumma balighna Ramadan. Oh Allah, unite us. Oh Allah, make us from the people who don't stand in lines. Oh Allah, make us from the people who our hearts are empty and cleansed, inshallah. Oh Allah, make us forgive us and accept us. Oh Allah, make us from the people who joined the Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam in Firdaus al-A'la. Allahumma aghfir lana dhunubana wa israfana fi amrina. Allahumma tawaffana salihin wa aghfir lana wa liwalidina wal muslimina ajma'in wa akhir da'wana alhamdulillahi rabbil alamin. Qumu ila salatikum alhamdulillah.